Number 77, Mark Glover Jr. is being escorted by Chrissy Crump and Mark Glover Sr. During high school, Mark has been involved in football, powerlifting, and track. Mark plans to attend Kingsville AT&M and study kinesiology. Congratulations, Senior Mark Glover. Athletic trainer Samantha Laughlin is being escorted by Lion, Kathy, and William Laughlin, and Jacob Snyder. Samantha has been involved in student training, been the soccer and basketball manager, involved in the school news and yearbook. Samantha plans to attend WCJC for nursing, then to transfer to UT or the University of South Carolina. Congratulations, senior athletic trainer Samantha Laughlin. Athletic trainer Sarah Avila is being escorted by Bianca Guerra and Willie Avila. Sarah has been involved in student council, has been the class president, played soccer and volleyball, ran cross country, played in the band, sings in the choir, and is also a student trainer. Sarah plans to study psychology in college to become a therapist so she can help people. Congratulations, senior athletic trainer Sarah Avila. Cross-country runner Megan Suarez is being escorted by Lane Suarez. Megan has been involved in cross-country, tennis, soccer, track, band, and drama. She plans to attend WCJC and then transfer to university. Congratulations, cross-country runner Megan Suarez. Cross-country runner Jonathan Posada is being escorted by Gerardo and Patricia Posada. He has been involved in cross-country, band, soccer, track, and culinary. He plans to attend WCJC to study kinesiology, and then transfer to a university. Congratulations, senior cross-country runner Jonathan Posada. Now we turn our attention to the senior cheerleaders. Cheerleader Addison Dingler is being escorted by Lance and Jamie Dingler. Addie has been involved in volleyball, cheerleading, and soccer. She participated in debate and informative speaking in UIL. She was also elected for Girls State her junior year, and she is also a class officer. After high school, she plans on attending the University of Texas at Austin and getting her degree in business management. Hook 'em. Congratulations, senior cheerleader Addison Dingler. Cheerleader Christiana Campbell is being escorted by Leticia Dean and Daisy Blunston. She has participated in volleyball, softball, soccer, debate, cheerleading, student council, communities in school, cosmetology, theater, and choir. Christiana plans on to attend a university to study nursing and later become a labor and delivery doctor. Congratulations, senior cheerleader Christiana Campbell. Cheerleader Justice Alloway is being escorted by Jackie Jordan. Justice has been involved in FFA, FCS, LDES, soccer, cheerleading, yearbook, student council, National Honor Society, and all AP classes. Justice wants to attend Texas Tech University and major in architectural engineering. Congratulations, senior cheerleader Justice Alloway. Cheerleader Precious Glover is being escorted by Nicole Robinson and Mark Glover Sr. Precious has been involved in volleyball, basketball, softball, cheer, track, student council, FCA, cosmetology, and the National Honor Society. Precious plans to attend a university to major in sociology and minor in social work. After college, she hopes to be a social worker or counselor for younger children. Congratulations, senior cheerleader Precious Glover.
Next are the senior band members. First member is Maddie Grew. She's being escorted by Brent and Chris Grew. She was involved in choir, art, culinary, health science, and band with the front ensemble her freshman through junior year and as drum major her senior year. Her goals after high school include attending Sam Houston State University to study criminal justice and become a forensic scientist. Her favorite memory in high school was skipping school with her friends and boyfriend to go to Splashway for a day off. Congratulations, senior Maddie Grew. Eurydice Harding, mother Leticia Harding, and father Neil Wilroy, being escorted by, involved in band for 4 years of high school, and joined cosmetology her junior year, and currently participating in that. Her goals after high school are to graduate with her cosmetology license and attend the University of Texas in Austin and major in small business, and then later open her own salon for hair and makeup. Her favorite memory in high school was being able to meet people and become friends with the ones in the band. Congratulations, senior Eurydice Harding. Next band student is Edith Martin, escorted by George Marin and Olga Marin. She has been in band and choir for 3 years. Her goals after high school are to go to WCJC and then transfer to Texas State Technical College to major in electrical power and control. Her favorite memory in high school was during her freshman year in band. Congratulations, Edith Martin. Next band member is senior Jonathan Holm, escorted by Christina Sosa, Johnny Sosa, and Jamie Sosa. He was involved in the band. His goals after high school are to finish school and to go to college. His favorite memory is during the war chant and being able to dance and sing with his favorite band members. Ladies and gentlemen, senior Jonathan Holm. Senior Jeanette Porch, being escorted by Samantha and Lamont Porch, was involved in band, basketball, and softball during her time at Rice High School. Her goals after high school include attending Texas State University to become an elementary science teacher. Her favorite memory in high school is there's just too many to have one. Congratulations, senior Jeanette Porch. Next is senior Emma Holscher, being escorted by Lisa, John, and Abigail Holscher. Her activities involved during her time at Wright High School is FFA, Color Guard, and UIL Lit Crit. Her goals after high school are to go to WCJC to major in radiology technician. Her favorite memory in high school is for her family always being there for her and helping her believe what she couldn't believe was possible. She's very thankful for that and doesn't know what she could have done without them. Congratulations, senior Emma Holscher. Next is senior Chris Gonzalez, being escorted by Patricia and Rosa Gonzalez, was involved in the band in Rice High School, and his goals after high school is to start working and get a job. His favorite memory while in high school was playing Elmo at every football game. Congratulations to senior Chris Gonzalez. Next is senior Kiara Pacheco, being escorted by Irma Anchondo. Activities involved at Rice High School were color guard and cosmetology. After high school, she'd like to go to WCJC to study criminal justice. And her favorite memory in high school was when she was a freshman in band. Congratulations, Kiara Pacheco. Last and certainly not least, Sebastian Llanos is being escorted by Coach Gray. Activities involved at Rice High School was band and AV class. His goals after high school are to go to Blinn and then A&M so he can study engineering. His favorite memory while in high school was getting straight ones in marching season his freshman year. Congratulations, Sebastian Llanos, and congratulations to all the seniors of the Rice High School band. Congratulations, seniors. Way to go.
Once again, congratulations, senior, and truly, way to go as you continue in your journey for high school graduation. Thank you, seniors. And now we want to do something a little different tonight. Normally about sometime in the third quarter, we introduce you the varsity cheerleaders. Tonight, we're going to introduce them before the game ever gets started. All right, so we're going to introduce our varsity cheerleaders. I want you to put your hands together for our 2021-22 varsity cheerleaders. Captain, senior, All-American, Addie Dingler. Co-captain, junior, Brady Freeman. Senior, All-American, Precious Glover. Senior, Christiana Campbell. Senior, Justice Alloway. Junior, All-American, Reagan Nelson. Junior, Lacey Romo. Sophomore, Jacqueline Longoria. Sophomore, Adeline Rogers. Sophomore, Kayla James. Freshman, Abby Holscher. Freshman, Crystal Martinez. And our mascot, freshman, Taylor Rohan. Along with two JV cheerleaders, Leilana Torres and Ali Sosa. Our cheer coach, Kirby Quintero. This is our 2021-22 cheerleaders. Welcome. Thank you for all that you do. Once again, welcome to Greater Metropolitan Altair, Texas, and Rice Veterans Memorial Stadium for tonight's district game between the 2-6 Brazos Cougars and your 2-7 Rice Raiders. This game is being conducted according to the rules and regulations of the University Interscholastic League. Regardless of the outcome of tonight's game, all of the players have proven their willingness to work and sacrifice in order to achieve athletic excellence. We ask that as a spectator, you consider the time and effort each of these teams, coaches, and athletes have put forth. Cheer these young athletes and applaud them, but do not, through any of your actions, cause them to doubt the value of athletics. By your conduct, allow these young people to feel pride in their communities and school. While your sportsmanlike action may play only a small part in the outcome of this game, it will play a greater role in continuing to encourage competitive athletics. We also ask that you show your appreciation for the students who will be taking part indirectly in tonight's game, the cheerleaders, the bands, the pep squad, and the students who have supported their team at home and away. These young people play an integral part in their team's success. The officials for this game have been mutually agreed upon by school officials for both schools. Their role is not unlike those of players, coaches, teachers, and school administrators. Without them, this game would not be possible. Their knowledge and application of the rules are a result of annual testing, years of study, and continual participation in clinics that further refine their understanding of the game. We ask you as students, as parents, and citizens, to demonstrate the kind of respect for these officials you would extend to any dedicated person in a position of responsibility. This means that you as a fan should not criticize the players on either team. You should not boo the officials. You should not have alcoholic beverages on public school grounds, since this is a violation of state law. You should be courteous to the visiting fans, and you should cheer for your team, and you should show respect for injured players on both teams. Enjoy tonight's game. Yell for your team, cheer loud, and have a good time tonight as the Rice Raiders and the Brazos Cougars face each other here at Rice Veterans Memorial Stadium. To our friends and fans from Brazos, we want to welcome you to Altair, Texas, and to Rice Veterans Memorial Stadium for tonight's game. If you are new to the area, we want you to know that the concession stand is located in the south end zone. Also, the restrooms are located immediately behind the concession stand. Also tonight, we'll be coming through for 50-50 tickets. 50-50 tickets. Half of the proceeds go to Project Graduation, and the winner takes home the other half. Buy your 50-50 tickets tonight, as the winning ticket will be drawn at the close of the halftime festivities. Tonight's national anthem will be sung by the combined junior high and high school choir. Under the direction of Laura Esparza, they will be singing the national anthem just prior to kickoff. We welcome the Cougar Band tonight and invite you to get ready to play your alma mater. Cougar Band, get ready to play your alma mater. Hope you all are enjoying the sunset. Beautiful sunset tonight. It's going to be a beautiful evening for football. We invite the Cougar Band to play their alma mater. Thank you, Cougar Band. And now, Raider fans, turn your attention to the mighty Raider Band. As under the direction of Luis de la Garza, the Raider Band plays the Rice Alma Mater. Thank you, Raider Band. Here come the Raiders! Welcome, the Brazos Cougars! Will you please stand? As a part of our opening ceremonies and before the singing of our national anthem, we invite your warmest and most serious attention, reflection, forbearance, generosity, and care for our nation, for our schools, for all our student participants who are competing or performing here tonight. For good sportsmanship on the field and in the stands, and for all who will be traveling home after this game, please remain standing as the combined junior, high, and high school choir, under the direction of Laura Esparza, sing our national anthem. Thank you, choir members. Put your hands together one more time for the combined junior high and high school choir under the direction of Laura Esparza. Once again, thank you, choir. Great job on the national anthem. Captains meet at midfield for the coin toss. Brazos won the toss. They've elected to defer the ball until the beginning of the second half. Rice will receive Brazos kickoff. Don't forget, they're selling 50-50 tickets tonight. Be your last chance. This is our last home game. Be a last chance for during the football season for you to be a benefactor to Project Graduation. Buy your 50-50 tickets. Number 20, Yordi Perez, is kicking off for the Cougars. Short kick picked up by the short man. And that's where the Raiders will take over. First and 10 on their own 42-yard line. As Darren Johnson recovered the kickoff. The Rice ball, first and 10 on their own 42-yard line. Number 9, Ralph Herrera, quarterback for the Raiders. Johnson on the scamper. makes his way all the way. Touchdown, Rice. Gonzalez on to kick the extra point. Extra point is no good. 11 minutes and 44 seconds to go in the first quarter. Rice 6, Brazos 0. That was freshman Darren Johnson on the 60-plus yard scamper. Elijah Johnson and Trey Gaston back to receive the Rice kickoff. Kicking off is number 3, Angel Gonzalez for the Raiders. Number 1, Johnson on the carry, swallowed up by Roger Gradney. That's where the Cougars will take over in their own territory. First and 10 on their own 17-yard line, 18. First and 10 for the Cougars. Javian Dickerson, quarterback, handed off to number 1, stopped just short of the 30-yard line, where it'll be second down. Elijah Johnson was on the carry for the Cougars. It's going to be second and 4. Second and 4. Bad snap, recovered by number 7, Dane Maka. That's going to bring up third down. Bring up third and about 20. Penalty marker on the play. Be half the distance to the goal. Illegal procedure against the Cougars. Bring the ball back to about the 3-yard line. Third down. Dickerson back to pass was incomplete. It's going to be a fourth down. Woo! Fuller back to receive the punt. Ball is dead at the 43-yard line, and that's where Rice will take over on the Cougar 43-yard line. First and 10. James Cotton in the backfield. Hand off to Cotton. Makes his way to about the 40-yard line. Progress is stopped, so it'll be second down. You'll remember James Cotton missed the last home game due to injury. Second and 8. Cotton across the 40, makes his way to about the 35. It's going to bring up third down. Third and two for the Raiders. Herrera on the keeper. Brought down about the 25, 24-yard line. And we're going to move the sticks because that's a Raider first down. Herrera back to pass, brought down for a loss. That's going to bring up second down. Going to bring up second. And 10, 20, second and 20. Bring up third down. Third and about 16. Herrera's pass is incomplete. It's going to bring up fourth down. Thank you. Herrera's pass was incomplete. Penalty markers on the play. Pass interference against the Cougars. That's an automatic first down. It's going to spot the ball on about the 16-yard line of the Cougars, where it will be a first and 10 for the Raiders. On the play. Could bring up second down. James Cotton lost his helmet on that play. Has to set out one play. Herrera's pass is incomplete. Gonna bring up third down. Third and 15. Hand off to Johnson, makes his way to about the 15, 16 yard line, where it will bring up fourth down. Fourth and nine for the Raiders. Ball resting on the Cougar 16 yard line. Timeout. Rice. That is their first charge timeout of the half, coming at 5:09 in the first quarter. All right, maybe you haven't had supper yet. The concession stand is open. Got some good nachos, got some Raider dogs, got some soft drinks over there, some candy. So if your significant other hasn't had supper yet, you might saunter over there and bring them back something to eat. Remember, the 50-50 tickets are being sold. You can be a very benevolent person. As you buy a 50-50 ticket, you may even be the winner. Number three is on for... a field goal attempt. Gonzalez. Angel Gonzalez. Holder is Herrera. No good. It was far enough, but it was off to the left. 5 minutes and 6 seconds to go in the first quarter. Rice 6, Brazos 0. So it's on their own 16-yard line that the Cougars will take over. First and 10 on their own 16. Bad snap. Penalty marker on the play, the false start against the Cougars. That'll bring up first and 15. Dickerson's pass is complete. Receiver brought down about the 23, 24-yard line. Be second down. Second and 7. Second and 7 for the Cougars. Timeout, Cougars. That's their first charge timeout of the half. Elijah Johnson on the carry. It's going to bring up third down. Bring up third and 4. Ball is resting on the Cougar 27-yard line. Third and 4. Dickerson's pass was almost intercepted. That's going to bring up fourth down. Aguilar back to punt. Fuller back to receive the kick. Fuller takes the ball on the 37. Penalty marker on the play. Finally brought down about the 33-yard line, but there is a penalty marker on the play. personal foul, horse collar against the Cougars. Be a 15-yard penalty. That's going to spot the ball right at midfield. Right at the 50-yard line, and that's where the Raiders will take over. First and 10 with 3 minutes, 24 seconds to go in the first quarter. Herrera in the backfield with James Cotton. Pass to DeAndre Cotton. Gets away from one, two defenders. Fights his way down to the 30-yard line. They're going to move the sticks because that's a Raider first down. Ball is spotted on the Cougar 30-yard line. Hand off to James Cotton, makes his way to about the 25, 26-yard line. It's going to bring up a second down. Second and 6, or a long 5. Second and a short 6, or a long 5. Cotton makes his way to about the 25-yard line. Going to bring up third down. Third and 5. Third and 5. Pickup of 1. James Cotton down to about the 21, 22-yard line. It's going to bring up fourth down. Fourth and 2. Cotton on the carry. Timeout. Timeout for a measurement. Hold your breath, it's going to be close. Anybody got a credit card? Put your hands together for a Raider first down. There he goes. Hey. Johnson on the carry. Touchdown, Rice. 20-yard scamper by freshman Darren Johnson. Angel Gonzalez comes on for the extra point. It's down, it's up, and it's good. 42.4 seconds to go in the first quarter. Rice 13, Brazos 0. Gaston and Johnson back to receive Rice's kickoff. 42.4 seconds to go in the quarter. Penalty marker as the ball went out of bounds at the 34-yard line. So the Cougars will take over on their own 38-yard line. First and 10. 42 seconds to go in the quarter. Dickerson still in at quarterback. Dickerson falls on the ball at the 27-yard line. That's going to bring up second down. Going to ring up second and about 25. And that's the end of the first quarter. Rice 13, Brazos 0.
Ah!
We're getting ready for the second quarter. We've got some JV players that have moved up. You may notice some new numbers. Number 12, Marion Johnson is a freshman. Number 50, Rustin Krennick has moved up. Number 50 from junior varsity. And also Daedric Johnson, number 90, also another freshman. Second and about 25. Dickerson's pass was complete. Going to bring up third down. Third and about 17 with the ball at the 33-yard line. Pass complete again. Receiver brought down about the 35-yard line. That's going to bring up fourth down. Fourth and 12. Fuller back to receive the punt. Fourth and 12. On the 25, penalty marker on the play, and he brought down about the 29-yard line. Let's see what all the laundry is about. While they're figuring it out, there's a hot chocolate and hot coffee in the concession stand. Hot chocolate and hot coffee in the concession stand. Personal foul against Rice. Cotton on the carry. We're going to bring up second down. Darren Johnson on the carry, going to bring up third down for the Raiders. Ball is their own 24-yard line. Johnson thrown for a loss on the play. That's going to bring up fourth down for Rice. Fourth and 6. And Roger Gradney goes back to kick. 25 was brought down shy of the 50-yard line. Ball's going to be spotted at the 47-yard line. And that's where the Cougars will take over, first and 10, with 8 minutes and 32 seconds to go in the half. First and 10 on their own 47-yard line. Penalty marker on the play. False start against Brazos. It'll back it up 5 yards, make it first and 15 for the visitors. Bad snap, number one picks it up. Elijah Johnson, he is brought down about the 33-yard line for a loss on the play. Going to bring up about second and 25. Second and 25 for Brazos. Dickerson's pass is complete. Receiver is brought down at the 40. That's going to bring up third down. Third and 16. Dickerson's pass is complete. It's going to bring up fourth down. Fourth and five. Is complete. Lost the ball. Incomplete pass. Referee say he never had possession of the ball. So that means that the Raiders will take over on downs. Ball is going to be spotted right at the 50-yard line. First and 10 for the Raiders. 6 minutes and 45 seconds to go in the half. Stick around for halftime performances as two very well-talented, good-talented, multi-talented bands perform their halftime performances. DeAndre Cotton in the backfield. Hand off to all right, when it's all said and done, it's going to be Rice's ball, second down. But on their own, about their own 25-yard line. It's going to bring up second and 35. Thank you. Herrera's pass to Fuller is incomplete. That's going to bring up third down. Third and 35. Pass was incomplete. That's going to bring up fourth and 35. Fourth and 35 for the Raiders. 5 minutes and 44 seconds to go in the first half. Gradney's kick goes out about the 45-yard line. So that's where the Cougars will take over. First and 10 on the Rice 45-yard line. First and 10 for Brazos. Maka on the carry. He's being driven back. Going to bring up second down. Let's see where they stop his forward progress. Just inside the Cougar 50-yard line. They'll bring up second down and 15. Dickerson's pass is incomplete. It's going to bring up third down. Pass is complete. That's going to bring up fourth down, fourth and about seven. Fourth and seven for Brazos. Thank you. Timeout. Cougars. That's their second charge timeout of the half. It's 4th and 7, 4 minutes and 9 seconds to go in the half. Dickerson back to pass. Pass was complete. Stepped out of bounds around the 20-yard line. That's going to be a first down for the Cougars. Ball is spotted at the Rice 22-yard line. That's where it's going to be first and 10 for Brazos. Johnson on his way to pay dirt. No laundry on the field. Touchdown for Brazos. Bad snap, but it's good for a two-point conversion. 3 minutes and 48 seconds to go in the first half. Rice 13, Brazos 8. We're going to bring all this back. We're going to do the point after again. Fifteen-yard penalty against Brazos. Dickerson's pass is incomplete. So, 3:44 to go in the first half. Rice 13, Brazos 6. Fuller on the carry, brought down about the 34-yard line. That's where Rice will take over, first and 10 on their own 34 with 3 minutes and 36 seconds to go in the half. James Cotton in the backfield with Herrera. Hand off to Cotton. Makes his way up to about the 34-yard line. They're going to bring up second down. Second down for the Raiders. Second and 9. Darren Johnson on the carry, going to bring up third down. Third and a long 6. Remember, hot chocolate, hot coffee in the concession stand. Get your 50-50 tickets. Drawing will be at the close of the halftime festivities. Cotton on the carry to about the 32-yard line. End of the first half, Columbus 21, Bowling 7. Penalty marker on the play. False start against the Raiders. It's going to back it up 5 yards. That brings up 4th and 12. Quick kick, penalty marker on the play. Ball rolls out at the Rice's 30-yard line. However, there is a flag on the field. Minute and 23 seconds to go in the half. Ball is spotted at the Cougar 36-yard line. That's where they will take over, first and 10. Dickerson's pass is incomplete, intended for Dane Maka. It's going to bring up second down. Pass is complete. Brought down about the 30-yard line. That's going to be a first down for the Brazos. One minute and 8 seconds. Elijah Johnson on the carry. Run out of bounds. Bring up second and five. Second and five. Dickerson's pass is incomplete. Going to ring up third down. Dickerson back to pass. Pass is broken up. R.J. Myers helping to break that pass up. Timeout, Cougars. Fourth and five when play resumes. That's their third and final timeout of the first half. Thank you. Pass is incomplete. That means that the ball will go over on downs. It'll be first and 10 for the Raiders. 47 seconds to go in the half. Ball will be spotted on the Raider 26-yard line. First and 10. Ball carrier brought down about the 30-yard line. Raza says there was an exchange. Johnson was on the carry. Bring up second down. And that's the end of the first half. Rice 13, Brazos 6. Stick around for two great halftime shows by the Rice Raider Band and the Brazos Cougar Band.
Ladies and gentlemen, for your halftime entertainment, Brazos High School is proud to present the Mighty Cougar Marching Band. The band is under the field direction of drum majors Joshua Martinez and Jackie Aguardo. Color guard captains are Caroline Babrichka and Marlena Nunn. Tonight, the band will be performing their UIL 2021 UIL show entitled Return of the Samurai. Band members of the week are the entire band and the color guard. band is under the direction of Alan Garcia and Dahlia Lee. Color guard choreographer is Kimball Swagger. Enjoy the rest of the game and go Cougars!
Thank you, Cougar Band. All right, folks, we're getting close to the 50-50 drawing. Tickets are still available. You can still be a very benevolent person and help out Project Graduation by buying a 50-50 ticket. The drawing will be at the close of the Rice Band performance. Get your 50-50 tickets.
Please welcome to the field the Rice High School Raider Band. The band is under the direction of Mr. Luis de la Garza, Mr. Roberto Palomino, and Mrs. Laura Esparza. The drum major for the band is Matty Grew. The band member of the week is Julissa Barbosa. The band will be performing their UIL marching program entitled Alien Invasion. Alien Invasion is written by Luke McMillan.
Thank you.
Raider Nation, thank you for a great year and being a super audience to our band. We look forward to next year. Give our band a big round of applause.
Your hands together one more time for the mighty Raider Band. Okay, get your 50-50 tickets ready. Get your 50-50 tickets ready. $242 going to the winner. $242 going to the winner. Here we go. The winning number tonight for $242, the winning number 521936. 521936. We're looking for a winner with a chicken dinner. 521936. $242 to that ticket holder. Anybody out there? 521936. Come on up to the press box if you have that number. Folks, you won't believe who won. Laura Esparza, the choir director and assistant band director and one of the art teachers as well. All right, Laura Esparza wins $242, but the big winner is Project Graduation.
Funny, though.
Second half gets underway. Brazos will receive the Rice kick as they, Brazos won the toss at the beginning of the game. They elected to defer receiving the ball until the second half. So Rice will be kicking off to the Cougars as we begin the second half. The tunnels are rocking and are rolling. And here they come. Welcome your Rice Raiders as they come out for the second half. The final game of the year, second half. Welcome the Raiders. Elijah Johnson, number one, number 25, Trey Gaston going back to receive the kickoff. Angel Gonzalez, junior kicker for the Raiders. As we get the final half of the 2021 football Rice season underway, I want to thank you for your participation this year. Boom! Second half's underway. Ball carrier run out of bounds about the 30-yard line. Number one, Elijah Johnson was the ball carrier. That's where the Cougars will start on their own 29-yard line, be first and 10. Number 8, Javian Dickerson at quarterback for Brazos. In the backfield with Elijah Johnson. Penalty marker on the play. False start against the Cougars. It'll be first and 15. First and 15 for Brazos. Pass is incomplete, intended for Johnson. It's going to bring up second down, second and 15. Once again, I want to give a shout out to the junior and senior high choir as they open the game with the national anthem today. Thank you. Second and 15. Hand off to Johnson, brought down about the 25-yard line. That's going to bring up third down. Third and 14 for Brazos. Pass is complete. It's going to bring up fourth and 5. Fourth and 5. Ball on the Cougar 33-yard line. Fuller back to receive the punt. Fuller receives the punt at the 28-yard line, brought out to about the 35. That's where Rice will take over, first and 10. 10 minutes, 7 seconds to go in the third quarter. James Cotton in the backfield. Hand off to Cotton. Run out of bounds about the 40-yard line. That's going to move the sticks for a Raider first down. Thank you. going to be first and 10 for Rice on the Cougar 40-yard line. James Cotton on the carry again across, down across the 40, down to about the 38, 39-yard line. It's going to bring up second down. Second and a long eight. Hand off to Andre Cotton. Makes his way to about the 39-yard line. It's going to bring up third down. Loss on the play. Third and 10. Third down. Herrera being chased. He unloads the ball. That's going to bring up fourth down. Fourth and 10 for the Raiders. Quick kick. Ball goes into the end zone for a touchback. So with 8 minutes and 8 seconds to go in the third quarter, Cougars will take over. Ball spotted on their own 20-yard line, where it'll be first and 10 for Brazos. Direct snap to Johnson. Makes his way up close to the 20-yard line. That'll bring up second down. No gain on the play. Second and 10. Dickerson's pass is complete. Receiver stopped about the 25-yard line. Going to bring up third and four. Third and four for Brazos. Penalty marker on the play. infraction is against the Cougars. 5 yards, bring up fourth and eight. Fourth and eight. Check that, third and eight. Dickerson's pass is incomplete. Going to bring up fourth down. Yard line. That's where Rice will take over on their own 33. 6 minutes and 8 seconds to go in the third quarter. Penalty marker on the field. First and 10 for the Raiders. Hand off to James Cotton, loss on the play. Bring up second down. Second and 13. Herrera's pass is intercepted. Penalty marker on the play. Intercepted by Elijah Johnson. He's run out in the vicinity of the 23-yard line of the Raiders. Penalty marker on the play. Unsportsmanlike conduct against the Raiders. We'll put the ball on about the 12-yard line, where it'll be first and 10 for the Cougars. Penalty marker on the play. False start against Brazos. Going to move the ball back to the 16-yard line of the Raiders, where it'll be first and 15. Johnson on the carry. Makes his way across the 15 to about the 13, where it's going to bring up second down. Second and 12. And Dr. Gregory, number 3. He's brought down about the 14-yard line. That's going to bring up third down. It's going to bring up third and 12. Long 12, short 13. Pass is broken up. It's going to bring up fourth down, fourth and 13. Dickerson being chased out of the pocket, brought down about the 12-yard line. As the ball will go over on downs, ball is resting on the Rice 13-yard line. That's where Rice will have it first and 10. 3 minutes and 42 seconds to go in the third quarter. James Cotton on the carry. Little or no gain on the play. Bring up second down. Darren Johnson on the carry. To bring up third down. third and eight. Herrera's pass was almost intercepted by Noah Gregory. It's going to bring up fourth down. Fourth and eight. Gradney back to punt for Rice. Reverse to number 11. Walk down about the 15-yard line. Brian Maldonado was the Cougar player involved in the reverse. So the Cougars will take over on the Raider 17-yard line, be first and 10. Johnson on the carry. Going to bring up second down. Second and a yard. Second and one. Touchdown, Elijah Johnson and the Brazos Cougars. Vinny Aguilar on for the extra point. It's down, it's up. And it's good. A minute and 14 seconds to go in the third quarter. It's all tied up, 13-13. Jordy Perez kicking off for the Cougars. Let's go, Raiders! Grandy picks it up at the 5. No laundry on the field. That's a Rice touchdown. Roger Grandy returns it. About a 90-yard run for Gradney as he returned it for a touchdown. Gonzalez on for the extra point. Herrera holding. It's down, it's up, and it's good. 1 minute, 1 second to go in the third quarter. Rice 20, Brazos 13. Fourth quarter score, El Campo 49, Needville 21. Fourth quarter score, Royal 37, Wharton 14. Fourth quarter score, Mathis 30, Palacios 14. Fourth quarter score, Columbus 28, Bowling 13. Third quarter score, Tidehaven 42, Danbury 8. Fourth quarter score, Van Vleck 19, East Bernard 7. Gonzalez kicking off for Rice. The ball has been touched. Scramble for it. Rice recovers. Rice recovered the fumble on the kickoff. Ball is spotted at the Cougar 33-yard line. 57 seconds to go in the third quarter. It'll be Rice's ball, first and 10. Halftime score, Yoakum 54, Hempstead 0. Ball carrier down to about the 25. Darian Johnson on the carry. It's going to bring up second and 3. Johnson on the handoff. He makes his way up close to the 20. It's going to be a Raider first down. And that's the end of the third quarter. One more quarter of football to go in the 21 season. Rice 20, Brazos 13. Third quarter score, Hallettsville 38, Hitchcock 18. Third quarter score, Tidehaven 42, Danbury 8. And our score here as we begin the fourth quarter, Rice 20, Brazos 13. We certainly appreciate all of you Rice Raider fans that have been with us through thick and thin in this 2020-21 season. Look forward to next year. But right now, thank you for your participation. Thank you for your stick-to-itiveness. And congratulate these players as they come off the field tonight because they've played their hearts out just for you. Cotton on the carry. Made his way down to about the 5. That's going to be another Raider first down. That's going to bring up first and goal for the Raiders. James Cotton in the backfield. Hand off to Cotton. Touchdown, Rice! Penalty marker on the play. Unsportsmanlike conduct against Brazos. Herrera holding, Gonzalez kicking for the extra point. The extra point was no good. Penalty marker on the play. We also have an injured player timeout. Offsides against Brazos. We'll replay the extra point try. Offsides against Brazos. Ball been moved half the distance to the goal. Extra point is good for 2. Fuller on the reception. for the two-point conversion. 10:57 to go in the game. Rice 28, Brazos 13. The unsportsmanlike conduct penalty will be marked off on the kickoff. So Rice will be kicking from the Brazos 45-yard line. Luis Reyes was kicking off. Elijah Johnson. Penalty marker on the play. Elijah Johnson turned it all the way to the goal line, but there is flag on the play. Offsides against Rice. Penalty is declined. Touchdown is good. Extra point by Vinny Aguilar is good. 10 minutes and 40 seconds to go in the game. Rice 28. Brazos 20. Roger Gradney and DeAndre Cotton go back to receive the kickoff. 10 minutes and 40 seconds to go in the game. DeAndre makes his way over the 40-yard line. Okay, it's going to be Rice's ball, first and 10. 15-yard penalty against Brazos. That's going to move the ball into Brazos territory on the Cougar 43-yard line. That's where Rice will take over first and 10 on the Cougar 43-yard line. James Cotton in the backfield with Herrera. Cotton at the middle. Cotton into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. No laundry on the field. Gonzalez on for the extra point. It's down, it's up, and it's good. 10 minutes and 20 seconds to go in the final half of the 2021 season. Rice 35, Brazos 20. Got a final score, Columbus 28, Bowling 19. Columbus 28, Bowling 19. The last look at the East Bernard score, East Bernard was behind. Elijah Johnson and Trey Gaston back to receive the kick. Boom! And he goes out of bounds at the 21-yard line. And the Cougars say, kick it again. Five-yard penalty on the out-of-bounds kick. For the re-kick, the ball will be placed on the Rice 35-yard line. Angel Gonzalez tees it up on the 35. Boom! Johnson picks it up and is brought down at the 30-yard line. And that's where the Cougars will take over on their own 30-yard line. Be first and 10 with 10:14 to go in the game. Elijah Johnson in the backfield with Dickerson. Hand off to Johnson. Brought down for a loss on the play. That's going to bring up second down. Second and 13. We got a pick. We got a pick. Pass was intercepted. So Rice is going to take over on the Cougar 26-yard line after the interception. Herrera dropped for a loss. Gonna bring up second down. Pass is complete to Fuller. Check that. Andre Cotton. We'll bring up third and 11. Third down and 11. James Cotton on the carry down over the 25-yard line. It's going to bring up fourth down. Fourth and 8. Herrera's pass is incomplete. Ball will go over to Brazos on downs. Ball spotted on the 24-yard line of the Cougars, and that's where they'll take over. 6 minutes and 20 seconds to go in the game. First and 10 for Brazos. Hail Mary. Pass was incomplete. It's going to bring up second down. Pass receiver brought down at the 35. Timeout for an injured player. Injury timeout. Put your hands together for Trey Gaston. We want the best for him. Last play resulted in a first and 10 for the Cougars. Ball is on their own 35-yard line. Dickerson's pass. Was incomplete, intended for Brian Maldonado. Bring Bring up second down. It's going to bring up third down on the incomplete pass. Third down. Hand off to Johnson. Little or no gain on the play. That's going to bring up fourth down. Fourth down and nine for the Cougars. Fourth and nine for the Cougars. Timeout. Brazos. Fourth and nine for the Cougars. Dickerson's pass is incomplete. The ball will go over to the Raiders on downs. Minutes and 24 seconds to go in the game. The Raiders will take over. Ball will be spotted on the 36-yard line of the visitors. First and 10, Rice. Hand off to James Cotton. Down to the 30, the 25, the 20. Drug down about the 10-yard line. That's going to be a Raider first down. Ran out of bounds about the 18, so that's going to be first and 10 for the Raiders. On the Cougar 18-yard line. Cotton on the carry. Down to about the 14 before he's brought down. It's going to bring up second down. Second and five. Penalty marker on the play. Thank you. unsportsmanlike conduct on the Cougars. It'll be half the distance to the goal. It'll be an automatic first down. It'll be first and goal. Cotton down across the 5-yard line, be second and goal. Be second and goal, ball resting just inside the 5. That's DeAndre Cotton on the carry. Stop short of the goal line. It's going to bring up third and goal. Ball is on the 2. Third and goal on the 2. James Cotton in for a TD. That polka band music the band's playing. Gonzalez on for the extra point. It's down, it's up, and it's good. 3:39 to go in the game. Rice 42, Brazos 20. Johnson and Maldonado back to receive Gonzalez's kick. 3:39 to go in the game. 3:39 to go in the season. A pooch kick. Ball is on the Cougar 43-yard line, and that's where they'll take over first and 10 on their own 43. Incomplete pass. Covering up second down, second and 10. Dickerson's pass is incomplete. Intended for Brian Maldonado. It's coming up third down. Stepping off a penalty against Rice. Ball is in Rice territory on the 42-yard line. It's going to be first and 10 for Brazos. Dickerson's pass is complete. Touchdown, Brazos. Brian Maldonado, number 11, on the reception, on the touchdown. Brazos is going for a two-point conversion. Two-point conversion is no good. 3 minutes and 7 seconds to go in the game. Rice 42, Brazos 26. As we get ready for the kickoff, just want to take a personal moment and say thank you. Tonight's game will conclude 10 years that you've allowed me to be your public address announcer. I started with Brad Dumont, asked me to do this position. Coach Zeiner continued to ask me, and now Coach Sloan. You all have been a great crowd. I want to say thank you for all the words of support that you've given me over the years. I hope we have many more years of being a part of the Rice Raider and the Raider family. Just for 10 years, I want to say thank you for your support. -47 degrees out there, somebody just told me. That's one of the officials, so that's the official picture. Onside kick. We all make a run for it. And Rice is going to take over on their own 49-yard line, where it'll be first and 10. 3 minutes and 5 seconds to go. We have an injury timeout. Zelaya is the injured Cougar player. Herrera on the carry, gets across the 45 to about the 44. Well, that'll be second down. Second and four. Penalty marker on the play. Another penalty marker on the play. Darren Johnson on the carry. Let's see what all this laundry's about. Keep your eyes on the man in the white hat. We got holding against Rice. You can bring the ball back to the 45-yard line. Be second and 14. Cotton on the carry, stopped just shy of the 50-yard line. Going to bring up third down. Penalty marker on the play. unsportsmanlike conduct against the Cougars. He's going to place the ball at the 35-yard line. First and 10 for the Raiders. Roger Gradney, touchdown. Gonzalez on for the extra point. It's down, it's up, it's good. 1 minute, 50 seconds to go in the season. Rice 49. Cougars 26. Elijah Johnson, number one. Number 11, Brian Maldonado, back to receive Gonzalez's kick. Short man calls for a fair catch. Penalty marker on the play. Personal foul against Rice. Cougars take over on their own 48-yard line to be first and 10. Dickerson's pass is intercepted. Cason Brown on the interception. Brought out of bounds about the 35-yard line. Minute and 36 seconds to go in the game. Rice takes over on the Cougar 35-yard line, first and 10. Cotton down across the 30 to about the 29. Bring up second down. Cotton dragging a whole host of people. Be Rice's ball, first and 10 on the 21-yard line. Again, as we bring the season to a close, thank you, Raider fans and the Raider Nation, for your support this year. Stick around and congratulate the players. Final score, Rice 49, Brazos 26. Take care, God bless, be careful. Remember, don't text and drive. Stay alive.